Right now on Party Heat. The deputies help keep order as partiers celebrate the nation's birthday.
Get off the boat and get over here. Now you're going to jail.
A tough guy says he didn't do it.
I didn't flip you guys off.
Yes, you did.
We're trying to help you out. Then you're going to act that way?
Then, trouble at the sandbar.
One guy by himself?
No, it's like three guys. I'll show you who they are.
And Deputy McComas is on the case.
Next thing I know, here comes some people starting to attack me.
And later, things get serious at the bridge.
If he decides to jump, that backpack's probably full of weights. He's going to go straight to the bottom.
We're Spider-Man when you need him.
Lake Havasu. It's midway through the summer season, and the party hits a fever pitch.
Well, it's 4th of July weekend. I'm glad to see everybody's having a real good time. Hope everybody that's out here takes 5 seconds out of their day to realize how good we got it here in America.
4th of July out here is as American as anything else. People are off the hook partying with their flags and their fireworks, and it's a good time.
This is one of the few nights of the year where you'll have a lot of activity after dark, and it'll be right here focused on the bay for the fireworks show. So we'll see what the day will have in store for us.
I've been watching this guy jump the wakes. He just jumped one where he was about 10 feet from the boat. That's just too unsafe. We're going to go stop and have a talk with the guy. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Not bad. You know why I'm stopping you?
Oh, yeah.
How come?
Because I'm jumping the boat wakes.
You know it's illegal then, too, right?
100 feet back.
Why are you doing it?
I don't know.
Just thought it'd look cool. It'd be a fun thing to do, huh?
No, I just riding the surf.
Yeah. So you're a professional at this, or what?
No.
No?
Just starting out this year.
All right. Why don't you do me a favor? I'm going to turn my engine off, pull you on board real quick, okay? He'll hold on to the ski.
You take it for a ride if you want, man. Don't get your nightsticks out or anything. No?
I just got to ask you why. I don't know if you probably didn't see us over there, obviously. But you just thought like it'd be cool to do it, huh?
Well, no, I just
you didn't even know the boat, right?
No. They were just hooking me up, though, and I'm used to riding the ocean. I've been doing that. I go to California on the coast a lot, just riding those waves. And come on here, man. It's all flat. You just see this big old wake behind a boat. It just kind of sucks you in.
Yeah.
I'm paying for it, but you know.
Unfortunately, you're going to have to pay for it. You knew just, I'm going to do it anyways, you know. If I get caught, oh well, what the heck, you know. I get caught, no big deal.
Well, that's the thing, is I wasn't planning on getting caught. I didn't see you guys over there. But it's going to roll the dice so many times, right?
Exactly. It's going to crap out eventually. Or roll a seven.
Exactly.
Okay, what this is, a citation for, like I was telling you, for jumping the wake, and find you something to put that in so you don't have to worry about losing it, and you won't have no excuse about not showing up at court.
I can just hold it in my mouth and ride.
As much as you like to roll the dice, you never know.
All right, guys, take it easy.
Appreciate the attitude, all right? Jacob told me straight out he knew it was illegal. He just figured he was rolling the dice, so to speak, is what he was saying, and this time, unfortunately, he lost and the house won.
With thousands of partiers pouring in for the 4th of July celebration, deputies must patrol multiple Havasu hotspots.
We're gonna go into the Thompson Bay, check out the channel. It's party time out there, everyone's congregating, and we're just gonna go make sure that everything is safe and secure, and it's enjoyable for everyone.
Deputy Ogaz spots a man in distress.
All these guys down here can't help you get in the boat. Do you need medical attention?
His shoulder
apparently there's a male in the water right now stating that his shoulder's popped out of socket. He's having difficulty to get back inside the boat. It's unknown why the numerous people around him can't help him get in the boat.
There you go. Are you going to be okay? You can be able to take him back.
They can't tell how serious the man or his injury are, but just as Deputy Ogaz offers to send fire EMS out.
Ed, what fire to come out?
Well,
Okay, now he's being an idiot.
Oh, we're back in!
Let's just go hook him. Seriously, wasting our time.
There's a person right there that's obviously abusing the assistance that we offer out here, and he wants to play games and pretend like he's hurt when other people could be seriously hurt.
Well, this guy's far is about to end. Obviously, he's been drinking a lot. After he acted like his shoulder was out of place, then he showed us that it was not and started laughing and flipped us off. So we made contact with him and end his party right now.
Hey, dude. Hey. No, you come here. Get off the boat and get over here. I'm not lying either. Get on the boat.
I can't get on the boat.
Come here. Hey, Fooch, I'm gonna give me a hand. Nate, you gotta help me out, brother.
I can't.
Oh, and your shoulder's not out of place again, dude. Get up. Come back here and sit down. Hey, dude, we got other things to be doing out here besides wasting our time with some jackass.
You can't explain.
You're done. You're done explaining what you showed us, that your shoulder was not hurt, and then you want to flip us off. Now it's done.
Flip us off?
Yeah. So now you're going to jail.
That
no.
Shoulder surgery.
I don't care.
Right here, it went out.
We have better things to be doing out here. But you jacked around.
I did not lie to you guys at all. This popped out. I promise you guys. I'm not lying to you. I swear to God.
Okay.
This is shoulder surgery.
Well, then maybe you shouldn't have flipped us off then.
I didn't flip you guys off.
Yes, you did.
Okay. Don't sit here and start telling us different.
Is it funny anymore?
No.
You didn't cry wolf like that. All of a sudden, you're going to respond.
It was really pulled out.
We're trying to help you out, then you're gonna act that way?
I'm sorry.
Now you can just go to jail, dude. You can entertain your friends that way.
What am I going to jail for?
Drunk in public. It's that simple. You wanted our attention, dude, you got it.
Scoot over. Keep your hands out in front of you, put them on your knees.
Strap that up around you.
It'll help support that shoulder of yours, dude.
He's being arrested for public intoxication right now. Obviously, he's having problems. Maybe he is injured. Who knows with this guy? It's one story to the next. So if he needs medical attention, we're going to get him medical attention. But right now, it just looks like he's just being an intoxicated jerk. And that's a person that, if we decided to leave, is going to start creating problems for other boaters and possibly even himself.
Hot. Let's go, dude. This is the thing about it. This is typical of alcohol. You know, back at home, this guy's a teacher. Because of alcohol today out here, he wants to act like the class clown. And so I guess basically he got put on a little bit of time out.
Coming up on Party Heat.
You guys foreigners or what?
Scotland.
Deputies catch a couple aliens misbehaving.
They're not drinking, they're just foreign. Driving while foreign.
And later, Deputy Moyer gears up to save a desperate man.
Oh, he's getting more agitated.
Just get right up on it and then back off and I'll go in.
He's gonna wanna fight me if he wants to kill himself.
Thompson's Bay. It's Wednesday, July 4th. The traffic's picking up a little bit. It'll continue to pick up all the way up till twilight because of the fireworks show.
I don't mind people coming here and partying. On Monday, they usually leave, so the rest of us can enjoy the lake as long as they show a little respect and don't destroy things. It's a good time.
Got a couple jet skis over here violating an awake zone area. So we're gonna stop them, make contact, see what's going on. Cut it. Turn it off. All right, you gotta slow down, huh? In here, see everybody going slow?
Yeah.
See how slow they're going?
Fast.
Yeah, no gas in here.
Okay.
I know it's hot, but.
Yes.
Yeah.
Try to get back quicker.
I know. No. You gotta slow down. You guys foreigners or what?
Scotland.
Scotland!
The home of golf.
Been drinking?
Nope.
They're not drinking, they're just foreign. Driving while foreign.
All right, yeah.
Whatever that.
All right. Have fun. See you later. Here's a perfect example of people who come out here and rent a vessel and need a quick lesson on boating safety. Hopefully they'll make it back to where they rented those jet skis.
While patrolling the party, deputies receive a call of a man threatening to jump from Havasu's London Bridge.
We're actually en route now to the London Bridge. One of our units is out with Havasu PD with a person who is a hazard to himself and others, trying to harm himself and jumping off the bridge. So we're going to go assist the other units over there.
It's going to be right over here. You can see him between the two light standards. The negotiator's up top trying to talk him over the rail.
Don't do it!
First thing the negotiator wants to do is keep him calm and not agitated. So the longer it takes, the better, I think, the better it is for us.
Auto and boat traffic has been stopped. The bridge is shut down as Deputy Moyer prepares to move in.
And if he decides to jump, that backpack's probably full of weights, and he's going to go straight to the bottom. So what I'll do is I'll enter the water and go down after him, see if I can get his backpack off him and bring him to the surface, which is going to be interesting because he's going to want to fight me if he wants to kill himself.
Oh, he's getting more agitated. If he jumps, I'm going to go forward.
Okay.
Where's Spider-Man when you need him?
Just get right up on it and then back off and I'll go in because I'm going to give him a minute. Just I'm not going to go right in on top of this guy.
When you got a mentally disabled person, you just don't know what he's going to do. A lot of times you think you've got it under control and then he turns the tables and jumps. Taking his pack off, or he's readjusting it.
Yeah, matter of fact, I'm right underneath
him. He luckily came to a peaceful outcome. It appears their negotiators did their job successfully and took the guy into custody.
Probably be evaluated for mental disorders and treatment at a later date.
Coming up on Party Heat. A boater suspected of drinking and driving makes Deputy McComas's job easy.
How much experience you have boating?
A couple
what?
A couple beers.
Oh, I didn't ask anything about beers. I said, how much experience do you have on boating?
And later, reports of inappropriate photography at the sandbar.
Behind the boat, trying to hide, taking pictures.
This young girl came up and said, what are you doing? Take a picture of my mom.
Let me see that one. Hang on a second.
Fourth of July.
I think the people like to party out here because the atmosphere that everybody has about Lake Havasu is that it is a party location. Coffee canyons, the sandbars, the channel, anywhere on the water is a big party. And people don't care that they gotta climb on top of one another, tie boats up and be elbow room only. As long as there's a party, that's all that really matters. Inexperienced boaters cause a lot of the problems. They just, granted, you know, they got to learn sometime, but they buy a new boat or whatever, come out here and don't have any experience and take it to playground. How you doing, buddy?
I'm all right. How are you?
All right. How much experience you have boating?
A couple
what?
A couple beers.
Oh, I didn't ask anything about beers. I said, how much experience do you have on boating?
I got a certificate from the lifeguard.
Oh, from the lifeguard? What's the lifeguard got to do with boating?
Coast Guard.
Oh, yeah, they're a little different than lifeguards.
Yeah, I got a fire extinguisher. I got life jackets.
You got your Type 4. So you're doing everything great. I appreciate that. That's
yes,
good.
Sir.
Got life jackets on the grills. I really appreciate
yes,
that. You familiar with your putting your stickers on your hull, the registration stickers, the year stickers?
Up to date, yes, sir.
It's up to date, but you know you got one in the wrong spot. You got one in front of the CF, which is correct, but on the other side, you got it at the end of it, which is not correct.
It's a California boat?
Yeah. I'm a California cop.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you have
it's,
your.
It's all registered.
Oh, I know. I see that. That's great. Yeah. You feel like you're okay to operate a boat?
Yes, sir.
So you don't mind if my deputy back here checks you out to make sure, right? All right. Let's come on over.
Thank you. Thank you.
Is he good enough? Better nail him, but that's a good one. Oh, yeah, definitely.
Okay, how much have you had to drink tonight?
3-4 beers.
What time?
Between 11 and 12.
What time is it now?
Like 2.
Okay. How much did you have, you said? Between?
3-4 beers.
On the boat, we do a modified finger to nose. Basically, we realize that we're on a boat and we're moving, so touching the tip. Listen to me, okay? Everything's about following my instructions and paying attention, okay? I'm only going to tell you one. I'm going to put your hands down like this and your index fingers out. When I say which hand, with your head back and your eyes closed, don't do anything until I tell you to. If I say left hand, you're going to bring it up, touch the tip of your nose area, and bring it back and wait for the next command.
Yes, sir.
You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can call it. I'll just write them down.
Right. Go ahead and put your hands on your side when you're done. Left. Right. Right. Put your hands up. Okay, go ahead and open your eyes for me. You can relax.
Okay, what we have now is a preliminary alcohol screening device, okay? What you're doing that, blow into it like you're blowing up a balloon. It's going to give us an idea what your blood alcohol content is. This is he's at a 0.26 right now, so.
Is that legal?
Okay, you know what the legal limit is in California?
0.08.
0.08, you're 0.26. Would you think that's a little bit extreme? Yeah, so you understand what has to happen now? Okay. What's going to happen is we're going to give you a life jacket. You're going to be arrested for boating under the influence.
Is there any way you can drive me down there in the boat?
No. Are you going to cooperate with me so I
yes,
don't handcuff
yes,
you in the back?
No, you don't got to. I'm
okay.
Not going
to. For me.
No, I'm not going to be stupid.
Just goes to show you that with the small violations such as registrations, they can turn into something major. I consider this major because somebody that's a 0.26 with the blood alcohol content most definitely has a likelihood of injuring themselves or somebody else out here. I feel good about taking them off the water. I feel like I may have saved somebody's life.
Coming up on Party Heat.
This young girl came up and said, what are you doing? Take a picture of my mama.
A snap-happy photographer sends this woman into a rage.
It's like three guys. I'll show you who they are.
Who's on this boat? Okay, is there a camera being used to take pictures? It's about 5:30 in the afternoon. We're in Coffee Canyon. And it's about time everybody starts rolling out of here and head over to Thompson Bay so they can watch a fireworks show. And a flag down over here. We got something going on here. Hang on.
What's the trouble?
There's a pontoon over there, red and black.
Black?
Pontoon, red and black. Taking pictures of kids.
Red and black pontoon?
Yes. Right over, taking pictures of kids.
One guy by himself?
No, he doesn't. It's like three guys. I'll show you who they are.
We asked them to stop taking pictures,
they
and they
continue.
Kept taking pictures again. It's the first pontoon. It's black and gray with the gray top.
I'll show you who they are.
Well, people are saying that there's some guys over here taking pictures of young kids, and typically that's a sign of people wanting to look at young kids that shouldn't be, so we're going to go contact them and see what's going on. Good indication, the guy with the Speedos is one of them.
Right there. Yep.
Who's on this boat?
About five, sir.
Okay, is there a camera being used to take pictures?
I have a camera, which I went over and took two pictures of two girls who waved at me. I went over and asked if I could take their picture. They said, yes, I can. They started posting.
How old were they?
35.
Is it a digital?
Sir?
Is it a digital?
Yeah.
Would you mind showing me
sure.
the pictures?
And they walked up the beach. Next thing I know, here comes some people started attacking me. What are you taking their picture for? And I said,
Why don't you, if it's your camera, why don't you let me take a picture, look at the pictures, and I'll determine if there are anything that we need to deal with. I just want to make sure there's no pictures of any small kids in here.
No, there they are walking up the beach.
Let me see that one. Hang on a second.
You know, and I asked those ladies, like, can I take a picture? And they started waving at me. This thing I know, this young girl came up and said, what are you doing? Take a picture of my mom. And I said, well, I asked her if I could take it. And she said, yeah.
Their concern was they thought maybe we were taking pictures of the little girls or something like that. And you know, and you would probably agree if that was the case, you'd want us to deal with it. But I don't see nothing like that on there. Stupid question, but I'm gonna ask you. You have never been arrested as a pedophile or nothing like that, right? All right, Carl. Thank you. You said you're taking pictures of the little girls?
Yeah, her. She was, me and her were laying on the boat.
I was just relaxing on the boat, and he's behind the boat trying to hide, taking pictures.
Behind this boat?
He was trying to hide behind that boat, taking pictures.
I looked at all of his pictures unless he had another disc. I just didn't see any young girls or anything like that. But her in a picture might look older to me, too. I might not.
Pictures of my mom right now when they were right there.
Yeah, but
I don't care if you take pictures of me, but the kids.
You get all these people drinking and everything else.
That's fine, but you know
they're gonna have an attitude. It's like best off just to stay away from them. Call us, let us deal with them.
Yeah.
You know, that's what we get paid for.
I feel bad for the kids though, because get the kids out of it.
Yeah, exactly.
It's someone's mom and then someone's sister.
Well, all right, guys. Thanks. Take care. Yeah, the guy came out here from North Carolina. He doesn't probably see this kind of scenery out there as far as the girls in bikinis. I got a little excited, took a few pictures. We got that cleared up, but. It's a sandbar. You gotta be careful when you come out here. You never know who's taking pictures.
It's Thompson Bay. The sun's going down. All the boats are starting to come out into the bay and starting to anchor out in preparation for the fireworks show.
Everybody's just kicking back, watching the fireworks, and it was a successful day because we didn't have any fatalities or major injuries.
Crazy K got an eye on tape.
You don't even know!